there's always a beginning. Beginning of a sentence, of a movement, of something exciting. But I always found myself returning to the same paragraph of the same book over and over and over again. Because the only people for me are the mad ones. The ones who are mad to live, mad to talk, mad to be saved, desirous of everything at the same time. The ones who never yawn or say perhaps a commonplace thing, but burn, burn, burn like fabulous yellow Roman candles. And today I finished teaching at around 3:30 p.m. and got a text from Jaden and Jay. I crossed the paths to the main campus's road and avoided all kinds of eye contact, and before I knew it, I was on a train. About an hour later, it turned out, the line that I was on did a whole circle around the entire city loop, which meant that I arrived spectacularly late. I got off the train and found Jaden and Jay leaning against a column of Flinders Street Station, and the meeting was like igniting a bunch of firecrackers. "You bastard," Jay said and whacked me on the back. "Where have you been?" Jay was positively glowing. He had just returned from a meditation retreat a few weeks ago back in Melbourne, and Jaden and I both agreed that there was a glow about him that was too divine. "Come on, bring it in." We walked down a side street and eventually ended up at a Rhodes Junction where Jaden settled down his bag and pasted another one of his poems on a wall. The cars passed us on the left, and Jay and I looked at the passing people, the bicycles, and the trains and thought the same thing. "We're back at it," he said, "we're racing through the streets. It's been way too long, let's get back to it. We'll get a beer and all. Let's start from there." And then we ended up at a rooftop bar where we caught a few things up. I said that I've been writing a lot of creative nonfiction, and Jaden said that he was still working on his poems. Jay, after his first drink, said that he worked with a nutcase on a ranch and wrote down an entire chapbook worth of prose on toilet paper. "During this meditation retreat, right, I kept getting told off," he said. "One day I was making a spear with the branches, and another day I was circling around a tree because I was so bored." He related his crazy stories to us, and Jaden and I nodded. We were trapped in our little town, Melbourne. Jaden was about to date a girl, and I was stuck on campus as a lit major. But we were both happy to listen to Jay's stories, the stories that we couldn't really quite get firsthand. After a few clinks of the glasses, we returned to the streets and started writing. There were a few spots we loved to hang out at. One was the old General Post Office. The building was beautiful, but it was later turned into a fast fashion clothing shop. It was quite ironic if I thought about it. We sat down and looked into the streets. Jaden read out one of his poems.
"The sirens every time. And my ears, every time. Police? Ambos? The whirs. One fire rescue truck so fast, so seething. Another right behind, so we know this must be serious. The way it's always serious when the sirens sound in the CBD. The man waits where Julie waited with her garden and her fear of sirens. But there's no train coming for the man. Just sirens and their songs, luring the human fear of their unchallenged seduction."
Dude, it was freaking amazing.
I tried to note down a few things for my daily entry in the aisle, and Jaden tried to convince me to get a coffee at 6 p.m. I said no and rushed out of the store. With a few bags of grocery, we danced down the darkening streets. All the bookstores and restaurants were closed, and the city was quiet. The streets began to empty, and we circled back around to the train station with the promise to never leave one another as long as the prose was still true and ringing.